So yesterday we discussed about weather elements and climate. Okay, so the last definition that we did is the definition of climate. The average weather pattern taken over a long time, say 25 years, is called the climate of that place. So in the next para it is given that the temperature of at a place is very high most of the time, then we say that the climate is hot. If it is cold, then we say that the climate is hot. Sorry, climate is cold. Okay. So in the next, in the table 7.2 and 7.3, the climatic condition at two places in India is given. The first place is Srinagar, Jammu and Kashmir, and the second is Thiruvananthapuram, Kerala. Okay. So there is the daily minimum and daily maximum temperature is given. Okay, so when we have to, firstly we will calculate the average temperature. So you know how to calculate an average, that the total of the observation and divided by the number of observations. So in this way also the average temperature is calculated. Clear? So now in coming to the next page number 72. We can see that the difference of there is difference in the climate of the Jammu and Kashmir and Kerala. Okay, Kerala is very hot and wet as compared to the Jammu and Kashmir is a moderately hot and wet climate is there. Clear? Moderately hot and wet climate for part of the year. Okay, and on the other hand, if we take the example of Rajasthan, it is very hot. Okay, and the temperature is in Rajasthan, it is very high. Clear? So we can say that the climate of the Rajasthan is hot or cold?
Hot.
Okay, and in the case of the if there is a desert, then we can say the climate is hot and dry. Here in the northeast, the climate of the northeast state in India, it is wet because it receives rainfall for the most of the year. Clear? So the climate of northeast is wet. There are some examples that are given. Some well known countries that belong to the polar regions are Canada, Greenland, Iceland, Norway, Sweden, Finland, Alaska in USA, Siberian region of Russia. Underline these polar regions. And the next examples of tropical, the rainforest. The countries where the tropical rainforests are found in India, Malaysia, Indonesia, Brazil, Republic of Congo, Kenya, Uganda, Nigeria. Clear? Underline these are countries where the tropical rainforests are found. So in this, now we will discuss, we have already studied about the climate and weather. So we will do the difference between weather and climate, and then we will proceed to the next, the climate and adaptation topic. Clear? In the first difference, the difference between weather and climate. So, can anyone tell me the first difference? Weather is? Short period of time. And climate is for long period. So you will make the proper sentence in the in this long period of time. Okay, and the next. Yes, which is Sarah?
Weather can change.
Yes,
weather. Climate change. Climate
Okay, in this there is a pattern. Okay, and it generally it changes. Okay. You can write here generally remain unchanged. How many years? So next point. Yes.
The pattern of the place is observed daily, but not observed the climate.
Okay. It is something same like the ये point same ही है ना same ही है हाँ जी. We can predict the climate. तभी होगा अगर weather तो unpredictable है it is right. Okay, we are taking the average temperature in the climate. Okay, so we can write it is unpredictable. But the meteorologist predicts it. Okay, but इसको कैसे लिखते हैं? So in this you can write it is difficult to predict. And if we are noting the weather for a longer time, then we can predict that the climate of that place. It is either hot or cold. Okay. And the second and the last point, you can write the difference definition also that it is day to day condition. Okay, of the atmosphere with respect to the examples. You will not write examples in the difference. Okay, and it is with respect to the rainfall, humidity, temperature. Okay, while on the other hand, climate, you can write the definition of climate that it is the average pattern. Clear? Average pattern that is taken, average pattern of the weather taken for a longer period of time. Just like fog, that is, just for example, fog and mist, that will affect the weather, but it will not affect the climate. Yeah, so you can write this point also. So now we will discuss about the. So now the next is coming to the next topic 7.3. Climate and adaptation. Here in this, the word adaptation. What is the meaning of adaptation? Okay, so there are specific features in the organism in which surrounding they are living. Okay, and what is habitat?
And the place where an animal lives.
Adaptation and habitat. So firstly we will discuss the adaptation. Clear? Adaptation, there are it is the presence of the specific features which enables the organism to survive in its surrounding. Clear? And the habitat is the natural environment or surrounding in which the organism is living. Clear? So now coming to the climate and adaptation. So you can see that the climate has a profound effect, that is great effect on the living organisms. All organisms are affected by the climate. For example, jaise ki in the case of desert, the climate is very hot. Okay, and the camel adapted itself according to the environment or according to that surrounding. Clear? And in the case of पोलर रीजन्स, तो पोलर बियर ने उसको अपने अपनी तरह के अपने आप को उस तरह अडेप्ट किया हुआ है कि द पोलर बियर कैन सर्वाइव इन दैट आइस कोल्ड कंडीशंस आल्सो। क्लियर? अगर हम इफ अगर हम ऐसे करें कि पोलर बियर को डेजर्ट में ले आए वो सर्वाइव कर पाएगा, अगर हम कैमल को आइस कोल्ड रीजन में ले जाए वो सर्वाइव कर पाएगा? नो। सो देयर दीज आर ऑर्गेनिज्म हैव स्पेशल फीचर्स, ओके, अकॉर्डिंग टू देयर सराउंडिंग, क्लियर, इन विच दे आर लिविंग। सो द Activity 7.2, take an outline map of the world, mark the polar regions in blue, similarly mark the tropical regions in red. So we have discussed that two regions, tropical region also and the polar region also, you have to mark it. Okay, when I tell you this activity to complete, then only you will complete. Okay, otherwise there is no need to do it. Okay. Now the first animal that we will discuss in the polar region. Firstly, we are discussing the polar regions. These polar regions are near the
north and south pole.
The two poles, north pole and the south pole, and the temperature is very low, and it is lower than in winter, it is lower than the -37°C in the winters. Clear? And so therefore this place is, the climate of this place is very cold. Clear? And there is presence of snow also in the polar regions. Presence. Yes, no present I am. So in the first para it is given the polar regions. The polar regions present an extreme climate. These regions are covered with snow and it is very cold for most part of the year. And the important point is for 6 months the sun does not set at poles, while for the other 6 months the sun does not rise. Okay. In winters, the temperature is lower than the -37°C. Okay, and still the animals are adapted to survive in this polar region also. Clear? So, firstly, we will discuss the first animal, that is polar bear. How it is adapted in the polar region. So, polar bear, it is white in color. Okay, so it shows it can camouflage. Okay, the first it is white in color, so it can camouflage in the white snow. So what is camouflage? They matches their surrounding, so it is very difficult to find them. So it shows the property of camouflaging. So the predators, then it gets safe from the predators also. You know what are predators?
Yes.
The animals that hunt or kill the other animals. Okay, so it will get safe from the predators. Okay, and it can also kill the other animals easily. So it can prey easily also. Clear? It is clear to you?
Yes.
So now the next thing, there is a strong smell, strong sense of smell. ज्यादा strong smell होने की वजह से इसको पता चल जाता है कि मेरा prey है, कि मैंने अब इसको hunt करना है या kill करना है. ठीक है? Strong sense of smell. And the next important point, two thick layers of fur. Thick layer of fur is also present. And the next is, so therefore there is thick layers of fur, that means it will keep it warm. Okay, it will not feel cool. ज्यादा ठंड नहीं लगेगी क्योंकि इसके जो है फर है, थिक लेयर ऑफ फर है. एंड अनदर इम्पोर्टेंट पॉइंट इज ब्लबर. यू नो व्हाट इज ब्लबर? द लेयर ऑफ फैट अंडर द स्किन. यस, ब्लबर इज लेयर ऑफ फैट अंडर स्किन. सो इट प्रोवाइडेड इंसुलेशन हियर सो दैट इट डज नॉट फील कूल. ओके, लेयर ऑफ fat under skin. Write it on your book. What is blubber? The layer of fat under the skin. And then another point, fifth point is yes, long and sharp claws. Therefore, it is able to walk in on the sand. Oh, sorry, on the snow. Okay, sharp claws, easy to walk on snow. That we will come to that. So these are the points that we have. Now next. So I am reading the para for the polar bears that is given on page number 72. The polar bears have white fur so that they are not easily visible in the snowy white background. It protects them from their predators. It also help them in catching their prey. To protect them from extreme cold, they have two thick layers of fur. They also have a thick layer of fat under the skin. Okay, they have. In fact, they are so well insulated that they have to move slowly and rest often to avoid getting overheated. Okay, insulation. Unki body bahut zyada insulated hai. Agar wo walk bhi karte hain, it gets heat. The body gets warm. Therefore, they have to rest so that they feel cool now. Clear? So the next para is the physical activities on the warm days. Therefore the polar bear goes for the swimming. Okay, so it is a good swimmer also. If you have any doubt up to this, you can ask. All points are clear to you? Okay, now the next is its paws are wide and large, which help it not to swim well, but it allows it to walk with ease on the snow, that we have already discussed. These are the points that we have already discussed. Okay, and then another thing is that it can close its nostrils for a longer time. Okay, and it can stay in water for longer time. Clear? And next we have discussed that it has a strong sense of smell so that it can easily catch its prey. So there is a flow chart that is given on 7.3. So it is easy to learn the adaptations of the polar bear. Clear? Mark it as a star that it is important. Now the polar bear is clear to all of you. Now next coming to the penguin. फिशेस तो वहां पे होती है, वो जहां पे ऐसा नहीं है कि वो सारा दिन वहां पे ठंडा ही रहता है, तो वहां पे जाते स्नो ही रहती है. तो इन द समर द टेम्परेचर इज मॉडरेट. ओके, वहां पे तब स्नो थोड़ी कम हो जाती है. क्लियर? इन द विंटर्स लगती है, तभी तो वो स्विमिंग के लिए जाते हैं. फिर जो हंटिंग भी करते हैं उनको किलिंग भी करते हैं फॉर गेटिंग द फर, बट इट इज प्रोहिबिटेड बिकॉज जो पोलर बियर का नंबर है इट इज डिक्रीजिंग, वो स्पीशीज है वो खत्म हो रही है, सो इसलिए ये बैन है. यस, बिकॉज द आइस इज मेल्टिंग ड्यू टू द हाई टेम्परेचर ऑफ द अर्थ, ग्लोबल वार्मिंग हो रही है एंड दे आर नॉट एबल टू सर्वाइव इन दैट टेम्परेचर, बिकॉज जो आइस कोल्ड कंडीशन है वो सर्वाइव कर सकते हैं बट इन नॉट इन द टेम्परेचर ज्यादा अगर वार्म हो गया तो नहीं वो सर्वाइव कर पाएगा. हाँ, क्योंकि थिक लेयर है, वो इंसुलेशन प्रॉपर है, बहुत ज्यादा इंसुलेटेड है उनकी बॉडी में से, ठीक है, और उनको ज्यादा गर्मी लगेगी. सो नाउ नेक्स्ट कमिंग टू द पेंगुइन्स. ओके, पेंगुइन्स आर आल्सो दैट आर व्हाइट इन कलर. ओके, सो दे आल्सो शो, दे आल्सो डू कैमोफ्लेज. ओके, देयर इज आल्सो, सो नाउ वी विल डिस्कस द एडेप्टेशन ऑफ द पेंगुइन. So how they are adapted? They are also white in color. Their wings are black, and therefore they also show the sense of, they also camouflage in the snow. Okay, and there is also thick skin. They have also thick skin. Okay, that thick skin and fat is also present in, under their skin. So it will keep it warm. Here, and the next is that they you have also seen the jo penguins hai zyada group mein rehte hain so that they don't feel cold. Okay, so you may have seen the pictures of penguins huddled together, that means they are living in a crowd or they are together. Okay, this they do to keep warm. Okay, now in the next is, like the polar bears, penguins are also good swimmers. They have webbed feet. You can see the webbed feet of the penguins in the figure 7.5. Okay, they have webbed feet. Okay, so and their body is streamlined. You know, streamlined body.
Yes, that's a fish.
Yes, penguins fish खाते हैं. So these are the good swimmers also, and their body is like streamlined. Okay, their feet have webs making them as good swimmers. On the other hand, the other animals that are present in the polar regions are fishes, musk oxen, reindeers, foxes, seals, whales, and birds. Okay, now Anjib, musk oxen, it is also a type of oxen that is available, that is there in the polar region, and the body of that oxen is covered with long hair and fur, black, mostly black. Nahi, it is different, it is ox, it is not like bird hai ye, it is Siberian crane. We will discuss about the migratory birds. Okay, so what happens in the winters, in the case of the polar regions, what happens, jo temperature hai wo bahut low ho jata hai, theek hai. So what happens, the birds migrate from that colder place to a warmer place. This is the migration. Clear? It is the mass movement of the birds and animals from the polar region or the ice cold the cold regions to the other place, that is a warmer place. Clear? So it is a seasonal activity. Wo winters mein jaise ki Siberian crane hai, it will migrate from that Siberia to the India. Okay, that means the Bharatpur in Rajasthan and Sultanpur in Haryana. Okay, these Siberian cranes will migrate from the Siberia to the India. Clear? It is clear. Siberia and north.
Northern region of Russia.
Yes. Now it is in the north. So then, now I am reading the next para that it is to be noted that why fish can remain under cold water for long, birds must remain warm to survive. Then they migrate to warmer regions when winter sets in. They come back after the winter is over. Here, you know probably that India is one of the destination of many of these birds. You must have seen or heard about the Siberian crane that comes from Siberia to the places like Bharatpur in Rajasthan and Sultanpur in Haryana. So underline this line that the Siberian crane comes from the Siberia to the places like Bharatpur in Rajasthan and Sultanpur in Haryana. So now we will discuss about the migration. What is migration? So firstly, migration is the seasonal activity. It is a seasonal activity. Yes. It is a second point. It is a second point. So we will discuss the topic migration tomorrow. Yeah.